ऐ सरजमीन हिंदुस्तान, तेरे उन जानिसारों, जांबाजों, शहीदों और मुहाफिजों को सलाम है, सलाम है, सलाम है, जिन्होंने अपनी बहादुरी की कलम से फतह की एक और बेमिसाल तारीख लिख दी। गवाह है आज भी कारगिल की वो बुलंद चोटियां, जिनको तुमने अपने लहू से सींच कर तिरंगे की आन बान और शान को रोशन कर दिया।
Welcome to all of you. We salute to our brave hearts. As a nation, we owe our success and progress to the men in uniform. The Kargil War, also known as the Kargil Conflict, was an armed conflict between India and Pakistan that took place between May and July 1999 in the Kargil district of Kashmir and elsewhere along the line of control, that's LOC. The Indian Air Force role in acting jointly with Indian Army Group troops during the war was aimed at flushing out regular and irregular troops of the Pakistani Armed Force from vacated Indian positions in the Kargil sector along the line of control. This particular operation was given the code name Operation Safed Sagar. The cause of the war was the infiltration of Pakistani soldiers disguised as Kashmiri militants into positions on the Indian side of LOC. The Indian Army launched its final attacks in the last week of July in coordination with relentless attacks by the IAF, that's Indian Air Force, both day and night in their totally successfully Operation Safed Sagar. The fighting ceased on 26th July, killing more than 500 and injuring more than 1300 Indian soldiers, and ended with India successfully pushing back Pakistani fighter to the other side of the LOC. Our flag does not fly because the wind moves it, but it flies with the last breath of each soldier who died protecting it. Jai Hind.
A very good morning to all of you. Today, I'm up here to pay my tribute to those real heroes of our motherland who mattered in Kargil War. I am here to put my heartfelt gratitude to them. My tribute. I do not know your name, nor from which battle you died. I do not know your home, nor the tears that were cried. I do not know where you rest, nor the promises broken. I do not know your uniform, and your fears lay unspoken. But I know your spirit exists, that your courage is admired, and your sacrifice honored by each soul that's inspired. And I offer you from my heart, thank you to guardians unknown for offering yourself for us all, that we may keep freedom our home. Bless.
To live in the hearts we leave behind is not to die, said by Thomas Campbell. Well, hello everyone, my name is Darjeet Singh, and today we will talk about Kargil Vijay Diwas. So as you all know that today is Kargil Vijay Diwas, that means India won a battle against Pakistan in Kargil and won on this day, that is 26th of July in 1999. Well, India lost many heroes, many officers that time, and all are in debt of those heroes who sacrificed their lives for our safety. So today we will talk about one of those greatest heroes, and one of them was Captain Saurabh Kalia. So Captain Saurabh Kalia was born on 29th of July 1977 in Amritsar, Punjab. He was educated in DAV Public School in Palampur and graduated from CSK Himachal Pradesh Agriculture College in 1997. Though Saurabh has given his medical examination but could not get a good college, his parents asked him whether he is serious about being a doctor, but Saurabh refused by saying that he do not want to become a fake Islam doctor. So, after completing his graduation from CSK, Himachal Pradesh Agriculture University, he cleared his CDS examination, that is Combined Defense Exam, and joined the IMA in 1997. Both his parents had gone for his passing out parade on December 12, 1998. Delighted that now he will start getting a salary, he told his mother, "Now you do not need to take any tension about money related problems. Ab main kamane laga hu." But neither he nor his mother withdrew any amount from his bank, as when his first salary was credited, Saurabh was dead. Saurabh was in the Jat regiment. He used to say that, "Today I am very proud of being a part of Jat regiment, and one day Jat regiment will be proud of me." On 15th May 1999, Saurabh and his five comrades was captured by Pakistani army. Post-mortem examinations revealed that Saurabh and their comrades has been tortured a lot by the army in every possible way. I cannot tell you what they did with our officer, but it was very devastating. They have crossed all the limits of humanity. It was called a civilizational crime against all humanity. When Saurabh's brother went to confirm his body, he told his parents that he was not able to recognize him and he just saw his eyebrows on his face. So you can imagine how much tortured our officers were. Dr. Narendra K. Kalia, the 70-year-old father of late Captain Saurabh Kalia, has tried and reached to every gate, every prime minister, every embassy he could to fight the case against the infringement of human rights and the violation of Geneva Conventions by Pakistan. But nothing has done so far, and he is still fighting the case. He is retired as a senior scientist in the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. According to Dr. Kalia, Saurabh was a soldier. His duty was to save his country, even if he has to lose his. If their son has to give life to save his country, then it is the greatest pride one parent can have. But to know that he was brutally tortured by the enemy army, and this should not be tolerated by any army, any parent, or any country. So his fight is still going on. Even there are more than 2 lakhs petitions have been filed for the justice for Dr. Kalia. International Court of Justice also could not do anything because it did not have jurisdiction over India and Pakistan. That needed to be sorted out bilaterally as per the Shimla Agreement. Well, this was the story of Kalia's family, whose son died during the Kargil war, and whose father is still fighting for the inhumanity done by the enemy army. Late Captain Saurabh Kalia was the first late Captain Saurabh Kalia's team was the first one to provide information regarding intrusion of the enemy army. Well, it is generally believed that to serve the country, one has to in the Indian army or any armed forces or any defense services. Well, my next story is on the same ground, that it is not necessary to be in defense to serve your country. In many great wars, many civilians helped our army in many possible ways. So my next story is related to this subject. Well, on 6th June 1999, that is in the mid of Kargil war, that starts from 3rd May to 26th July. So on 9th June, there was an announcement in which one All India Radio broadcaster said that India, your country needs your help. So Indian Army needs porters to carry out their load, their ammunition, their food. They seek help from Mrs. T. N. Moshuno to help in a possible way. So after this announcement, there were many volunteers came, right? But there was a problem, T. N. Moshuno. Mrs. T. N. Moshuno has a son who achieved 18 years of age. So she cannot say to others if she will not forward his child to support Indian Army. So she convinced her son Ricky to take part in the help. Ricky was initially scared because he was just 18 years old, but convinced later. So with this example, many locals step forward and help our army. Indian Army noticed that when a regular porter carry only 10 kg of weight, but these Ladakhis and Leh Ladakhis boys, they volunteers carry. Indian Army noticed that normal porters carry 10 kg of load, but these Ladakhis and Leh Ladakhis boys, they carry 30 kg of load very easily. So it was a great help from the civilians. Though they were given daily wages, but Ricky said that they were doing as much as they can do for their country. Even some of the boys helped in evacuating dead bodies. During the war, All India Radio also plays a very important role. During the war, All India Radio was in constant threat. Mrs. Angno Shuno shared that how they were in the constant threat of artillery, so they always used to have a car, a taxi outside their building. So whenever they start hearing firing, they just evacuate from their place. The radio station played a big role. The radio station plays a very important role in controlling rumors started by Radio Pakistan. They would broadcast any outrageous lies would be countered. Whenever there is any movement of tanks or any artilleries bombarded near the village, Radio Pakistan rumored about they have destroyed the tanks and have destroyed the civilians. So to counter those rumors, here All India Radio come forward and plays a major role. Mrs. Shuno recollects one particular night when there was no engineer to start the generator for the broadcast. So she called then commanding officer to send a person so that she can start broadcasting. So by these events, we can see that how civilians and army officers are dedicated to our country. So, and there were no awards for Mrs. Shuno, T. Angno Shuno, and for late Captain Saurav Kalia. But the greatest award is to make them alive in our memories, in our stories, in our heart. I think that would be the greatest award one can give to their soldiers. So on this Kargil Vijay Diwas, let's remember them all. Let's read about them. Let's watch a movie related to them, and always keep them alive in our memories, in our heart, and always pass on their bravery stories to our coming generation. And I hope their sacrifice will never be forgotten till our last breath. Thank you, everyone.
अभिमानी जो शहीद